The fourth episode of Mad Men's fourth season, entitled The Rejected, aired on August 15, 2010 on AMC. Here's a recap in case you missed it. The Rejected opens with Pete getting some bad news at the Sterling Cooper Draper Pryce offices. Lane and Roger explain to him that Tom's Clearasil account is in conflict with the larger Pond's account and will have to be dropped. Pete must break the news to his father-in-law. When he has trouble getting the words out, he winds up telling Tom instead that Trudy is pregnant. Ultimately, Pete leverages Trudy's happy news into getting Tom to hand over his multi-million dollar Vicks accounts. Don's evening with Secretary Allison comes back to bite him. During a focus group for Pond's, Allison loses it, breaking into sobs in front of everyone. Later, Allison confronts Don in his office and tells him she's quitting. When Allison asks Don for a letter of recommendation, he reacts indifferently. An angry Allison hurls a paperweight at him and leaves the office in tears. Don considers writing Allison a letter of apology, but ultimately gives up on the idea. Outside of the office, Harry persuades a reluctant Pete to meet for lunch with former rival Kevin Cosgrove. The two eventually agree to bury the hatchet. Back at the office, word of Trudy's pregnancy is spreading like wildfire. It seems everyone now knows, including Peggy. Peggy offers her congratulations, though she seems quite sad about the news. Peggy and Pete share a couple of tender smiles at each other. Peggy decides to accept an invitation from Joyce to attend an underground counterculture party. She meets several interesting new people, including artist David Kellogg and his friend Abe Drexler. When police raid the party, Abe pulls Peggy into a closet. The two share a kiss. Undeterred by the party or the raid, Peggy starts hanging out with Joyce's circle of friends, signaling that she's starting to embrace the new counterculture scene. For more information on this topic, visit the links below.